Vandals tear apart a Delafield cemetery.
Police say this isn't the first time the cemetery has been attacked, but this is the worst hit yet. 12 News' Kyle Reed joins us live, new at 10 tonight, to show us the damage.
Well, Toya, I can tell you the suspicion is that some partying teens did all of this destruction, knocked over tombstones, caused thousands of dollars worth of damage. Now, some very angry people want whoever did this caught quickly.
I actually stopped in my truck and is in awe because of the damage of the place. I mean, it kind of looks like a tornado went through here.
In all the years Joe Richmond's been doing maintenance at the Tabernacle Cemetery, he's found some minor damage here and there, but never anything like this.
Just can't believe, you know, people would do such a thing.
Sometime between Sunday and Monday, Labor Day weekend, someone knocked over more than 20 gravestones and ripped crosses and flags right out of the ground.
Yeah, it's senseless. This is a person, group of people that did this for no other reason except to vandalize the property.
The Tabernacle Cemetery sits on a windy country road. Some of the gravestones date back to the early 1800s. Police say teens have used it as a party spot for years. In this case, they have no suspects, no witnesses, just a wrench and some beer cans left behind.
If they think that we're not taking this seriously and we're not actively investigating it, they're wrong.
Now you got probably several thousand dollars worth of damage, and who's going to pay for it? You know, and that's why I hope they catch the people that did this and make them come out of their own pocket.
I did speak with a member of the family that owns this, that donated this property, actually. He was too disgusted to talk on camera. Police say they will increase patrols in this area. And as far as fixing up this mess, they say they may have to bring out some cranes to lift some of these tombstones. A lot of them weigh more than 600 pounds. Reporting live in the town of Delafield, Kyle Reed, WISN 12 News.
All right, Kai, thank you.